Welcome back everyone, Joe here from Data Analytics Ireland, video 2 of 8. In today's video on how to build a machine learning model, we're working on how to plan it and entails 3 easy steps, and they're coming right up. Step 1, researching your needs. Right, so you're setting out and looking to plan your model, but not sure where to start. One of the most common reasons for failure is the lack of a plan that is actionable. What you don't want is it to go in several different directions. Most definitely you don't want to do that. Question for you. Have you encountered this before in any projects you've worked on or been managing? Leave your comments and thoughts below in the section and let's get a conversation going. There are 4 topics we're going to look at. Bear in mind, you may want to add to this, but it should give you a broad outline of an approach to take. Decision. If you're building a machine learning model, you need to understand what problem you're looking to predict and where at the end of the process you'll be able to predict any outcomes with reasonable confidence. Completed work. Can you find previous work done on this before that you could review? If so, what new insights are you going to bring to the user of the model? Can you enhance that model with additional data you may have sourced? Benefit. What will it deliver so that the work you put in makes it worthwhile? If you predict the work that you are looking to complete, how long will it take? One of the more important things is availability of data. So what data do you need to build your model, and will you be able to access the source, your machine learning data, that provided gives you a meaningful prediction with confidence? This is important as availability of data and the quality will either make your predictions easier to predict but may take longer if there is a lack of data or its quality is poor or needs to be cleansed before processing, which can take time and adds to the project length you are looking to achieve. Step 2, building your model. So in order to build your model, there are a number of things we need to look at. So let's go through each one of these now. Data sources. So you want to get some useful data that enables you to create your machine learning model. Challenge as always, can they be amalgamated into more than one? And how can they be sourced and integrated to give some meaningful information? Remember, you be confident that your source of data has validated what they are providing you. Also, you need to be sure that the data will be available continuously for the period you're looking for to run the model for. You don't want to be running the model for a year and the data you require stops becoming available after 6 months. Certainly a big problem for you if it's a big, long project. Environment data processing. As part of the processing, the data necessitates understanding how big your data set is and what kind of processing power is required. The more complex the model is, the more power you need. Numerous online cloud environments enable the data to be analyzed and give you the output that could be analyzed. A decision where to process in-house or external third party needs to be made, taking cost and privacy considerations into account. Cleansing your data. One of the most important and time-consuming aspects of building a machine learning model is the quality of the data. Where you source the data and how much effort they have to put into cleaning can be fed into your plan and the length of time you need to spend on it. Remember, the more sources of data and the level of complexity of each can make this a longer process. Also, you need to build your model an initial step to cleanse your data, which helps to automate the process but adds more time to your plan. IDE choice. There are a lot of choices out there that allow you to program your model quickly. One of the critical things that are important to machine learning is the statistical analysis and getting some meaningful data that informs you about your data, what it's doing, and what relation is between the input variables. I'll put a link below to some packages that incorporate the statistical side, so be sure to check it out. Data correction. Just previously, we discussed the data sources and having more than one to input into the model. The benefits of having one source of data are that you have the consistency, accuracy, and completeness. Having more than one source requires some work to get it the way you want it, so that it can become one data set. While not impossible, both sets of data may have data variations in how they are stored and requires additional logic to correct before running the machine learning model on them. Engineering your model. So you've looked at some of the previous steps previous to this. Ready to build your model? But what are the questions you should ask before proceeding? Is your data set sufficient to give you an output that can be meaningful? Are you able to test the data set with either a subset of the data or another set of data? Our next video should help you answer this, so be sure to subscribe and hit the alert button so you can see what we can do with that. Processing power. Have you been able to establish how much processing you need based on the data set you're looking to analyze? If your data set is so large that the time and cost to complete your analysis will be too much. Right, so you've gone through your previous two steps. Let's talk about step three here, testing your model. When it comes to testing, it is vital to have a thoroughly thought out plan in advance. Our process followed here is called sample. It's an outline that supports you in coming up with some ideas. You can certainly add to it. So let's look at the first aspect of it, sample size required. Decide what sample size is required that you may or may not give you answers. Question, will you go about checking if you have the correct sample size? Leave your answers below. It'd be great to hear what people are doing in this field. Analyzing results. What is the process by which you will analyze your results? Based on what answers you want dictates how you build your testing strategy. Map desired outcomes. Write out what you're looking to test and what your desired outcomes are. Usually a hypothesis test type question should be sufficient. For example, how will the answer I'm looking for use the inclusion of X and or Y data variables in the model? Will I need to include more or change the variables as a result? Prototyping your tests. To get a feel for what your possible outcomes might look like and if your model should work, prototype planning is essential, as ultimately the build of this is what your final model will ultimately resemble. And learn. Once you've evaluated a couple of different iterations of your model, how you will decide which is the best fit. Evaluate your test models. You've completed the above steps. Do you need to iterate them again, or have you got your model bang on and to the exact requirements that you were looking for? Today we've gone through a number of different steps on how to build your machine learning model. We hope you've gotten benefit out of it. Please leave your comments below on the video on what you thought was useful. To get alerted to the next video, be sure to click on this link here for the playlist and subscribe. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time. Thank you.